As China has begun to open her cultural doors, we have been introduced to fascinating medical alternatives such as acupuncture and herbal remedies. Now another highly effective treatment system has arrived. It's called Qigong, a 5,000-year-old healing modality which may soon change the face of healthcare for Westerners in the 21st century. On the surface, Qigong is an exercise that builds the immune system and strengthens the body through a series of slow yoga or Tai Chi-like moves performed in synchrony with deep breathing rhythms. Upon closer inspection, Qigong reveals itself to be a self-healing tool using a moving form of meditation. The practitioners carry it to an intimate understanding of the connection with nature, the universe, and other human beings. Realizing this connection comes with understanding the essence of qi, the vital life force energy that animates the human organism. According to traditional Chinese medicine theory, qi is derived from the air we breathe, the food we eat, and the environment in which we live. Qigong is not limited to a self-healing system, but is also a treatment method for healing others on a body, mind, and soul level. Qigong's deep breathing and gentle exercise techniques improve our health by vitalizing our tissues, organs, muscles, and bones, relieving pain, eliminating stress, and strengthening our ability to emit qi for use in healing others. In the past, Qigong techniques were kept secret and practiced only by martial artists and the wealthy elite of China. Since the Cultural Revolution, however, scientific studies have shown Qigong to be a cure for diseases ranging from hypertension to cancer. Over 80 million people practice this self-care system each day in China. For the world's most populated country, Qigong seems to be the only financially viable healthcare option. For Westerners who are searching for alternatives to conventional medicine, Qigong may be the key to a more complete system of healing. The result of regular Qigong practice is a peaceful mind, a healthy, invigorated body, and a calm spirit that is more capable of dealing with daily stresses and disease. This documentary will take you inside the fascinating healthcare system of Qigong. We will look through the eyes of history, exploring its religious and cultural evolution, and then through the eyes of some contemporary Qigong masters. We will see how the current trend in searching for an effective, low-cost healthcare strategy is helping to create a place for Qigong in our future, a future that puts healthcare back in the hands of the individual. Not all Chinese accept the claims of Qigong on face value. To some, it is simply an antiquated practice based on superstitious beliefs. And in a country that is rapidly embracing things Western, the old is being discarded at an alarming rate. In what may seem counter to this trend, teams of Western-trained medical doctors are taking a serious look at the potential for Qigong to play a vital role in the increasingly demanding healthcare needs of the world's most populous country. In the heart of Shanghai, China's largest city, doctors Wang and Shu have amassed the most thoroughly tested data in the world on the effects of Qigong for treating hypertension. Their 30-year study shows conclusive evidence that qigong can indeed lower high blood pressure.
Our physicians prescribe herbs, lifestyle changes, and then various qigong exercises. We saw that blood pressure was controlled and the quality of life went up. According to traditional Chinese medicine, different people and different symptoms require different qigong exercises. But all qigong systems have three common aspects: regulation of the posture for relaxation, regulation of the mind, and regulation of breathing. We think qigong can cure every kind of disease, some responding better than others.
Across town at the Shanghai Qigong Institute, government-funded research is carried out to discover how qigong can be successfully incorporated into the country's social healthcare system. Dr. Shang Kai-yi studies qigong from a renowned master who lives far up in the mountains and works long days putting these findings to use in the clinic at the institute.
The only thing we can research now is the effects of qigong on patients, since no device can measure qi. We compare groups treated with and without qigong, and we see very positive results. It is this kind of research that will help Westerners believe.
In the capital city of Beijing, Dr. Wu Jin, a Western-trained physician and a qigong practitioner, heads up research at the Shi Wan Hospital. Although our cameras were not allowed on her facility, Dr. Wu shares her groundbreaking work.
After working for years with many, many patients at the hospital, we have conclusive evidence that qigong can assist in treatment recovery of nearly every disease. Post-operative recovery time was shortened dramatically in patients that used qigong over patients that recovered with standard Western techniques.
In Purple Bamboo Park, hidden amidst the hustle and bustle of Beijing, a loyal group of terminally ill cancer patients has formed a club. Frustrated by the hopelessness they felt from their Western-trained physicians, they follow a technique of walking qigong developed by the late Dr. Guo Lin in hopes of reversing their illness. Master Liu Shuhua learned directly from Mrs. Guo Lin, who suffered from urogenital cancer and was told she would only have a few weeks to live. Dr. Guo Lin lived 20 more healthy years, devoting her life to giving hope to cancer patients. These club members have all outlived their own terminal diagnoses by many years. The actual word qigong was only coined in 1962, but the principles upon which it is based are found in records thousands of years old. In an ancient tomb, these items are buried in hopes that the deceased, a wealthy nobleman, would have good health in the afterlife. This tortoise shell has survived nearly 3,000 years to tell us through its ancient inscriptions that people of that time believed deep breathing and specific stretching exercises would infuse them with the energy of qi and keep them healthy and vital. These drawings, dated to be about 2,500 years old, show ancient Dao Yin movements. They are part of a stylized tribal dance that helped alleviate aches and pains, presumably from rheumatoid arthritis, that was common with workers in the rice paddies and in other damp conditions. These dances were eventually broken down into specific moves that were prescribed for different ailments. Another way that the principles of deep breathing and mobilizing internal energy was applied was in the area of military battle. Systems like Wuji Qigong trace their origins to secret techniques and exercises coveted by warriors to make them better soldiers. At the Shaolin Temple, the revered 1,500-year-old Buddhist stronghold in Henan Province, the gentle monks eventually became known across the nation for their extraordinary skills in battle. Originally, this Chan sect of Buddhists, we are more familiar with as Japanese offshoot known as Zen, live ascetic lives and consume their time in deep sedentary meditation on the Buddha and a Qigong that focused on building a strong spirit.
The average man thinks of so many things, he must sit and not think of anything if he is to be truly healthy. If you're sick, don't think of it or identify with it. Sit and meditate, relax, take your mind off the sickness. Everything belongs to Qigong. If I return to the natural time and world, I will be free. Just like a point has three world coordinates, if I am free, I can move into unlimited time and space.
In 515 AD, the Indian holyman Bodhidharma happened upon the temple after a long journey. He climbed to the top of Song Mountain, and for 9 years remained in seclusion inside a cave. When he emerged, he began to teach the Shaolin monks a complete system of movement based on the way animals move in nature. He frowned on their sitting Qigong meditation, speaking of how Qi became stagnant and how this would lead to ill health. His forms became the foundation of the Shaolin Kung Fu fighting style that brought notoriety and political favor to the temple. The core of the fighting techniques lie in Qigong breathing and energy focusing principles. Bodhidharma, coming from India, brought ancient Hindu yoga techniques with him, and it appears that some of these premises are incorporated into Chinese Qigong. Thousands of Qigong styles developed over the millennia, some evolving into formalized routines that have become known as Tai Chi. Qigong is considered the core of both Tai Chi and the martial arts. Its fundamental premise is to use the breath to focus and mobilize energy throughout the body. Another influence on the development of Qigong in China was Taoism. Taoism is an ancient philosophical belief system with roots that go back thousands of years to the writings of the Chinese sage named Lao Tzu. Lao Tzu and his students lived in a time of great social unrest in China. They promoted a balanced lifestyle that adhered to the laws of nature. Observing the world around them, Taoists believed that their actions should harmonize with nature, reflecting the way water flows gently around obstructions or the way willows bend in the breeze. Their ceremonies honor various spirits and guardians who are infused with supernatural powers. Watching the activities of animals and celestial bodies became their inspiration for living a virtuous life and would serve to create a whole style of Qigong that focused on balance and building a strong body. Dayan Qigong, a Taoist style performed here by Master Fan Fuxing of Xi'an, is named after the big wild goose, and its forms reflect the natural grace of this beautiful bird. As the goose is a symbol of longevity, Master Fan says that this system will bring the practitioner good health and a long life. Over 1 million Chinese currently practice this 400-year-old Qigong system. Buddhism and Taoism are considered the two pillars that support the philosophy of the Chinese people. Their combined influence works together to create a complete way of thinking that has molded the evolution of Qigong over the millennia. Qigong is more than a set of exercises. It is an attitude that works to restructure one's perspective on life, leading to balance and harmony with the world around us. As the Tao teaches, life is an ever-changing process. The beginning of this century saw China in a state of moral and social decay, civil infighting, and eventually, war with Japan. The hope for a unified and stronger country led to the Cultural Revolution, which would dramatically force people to reevaluate their traditional way of life. Ancient practices such as Qigong, which were feared as old-fashioned, were outlawed and forced underground. Many masters left the mainland, as did the nationalist leader Chiang Kai-shek. For others, the practice of this ancient healing system stopped altogether, as intellectuals, monks, and professionals were persecuted and forced into hard labor on farms and in factories. When the Cultural Revolution came to an end in 1976 with Chairman Mao's death, China once again opened its doors to the West and to its own cultural past. Ironically, it was Mao himself who instigated research on Qigong to test its viability. Evidence was overwhelming that this healthcare modality would actually be a great benefit to the people. It's easy to learn techniques and ability to maintain health at a low cost brought it great favor in a country with over 1 billion people and a government responsible for socialized medical care. For this reason, Qigong has continued to be heavily researched and promoted by the government of China. The traditional method of learning Qigong is from a master, a teacher who has the experience to impart the subtleties of their unique system. One of these great elder masters is Duan Zhu Liang. He has lived most of his 90 years in Beijing. His teacher, in keeping with tradition, was his grandfather. His father was a guard at the Forbidden City, as was his grandfather and great-grandfather, who were both doctors. While they protected the last emperor, young Duan played in the courtyard and learned the ways of a warrior. The Duan family holds a lineage for the Wu Ji style of Qigong, which dates back to the 8th century, as noted in this ancient tablet, located in Xian. The tablet, known as Da Qin Jing Jiao, was discovered along the Silk Road and records the interactions between the Chinese and Christians traveling from the West. Master Duan, like his family, is a devout Catholic, and his unique form of Qigong encompasses the Taoist and Buddhist beliefs, as well as Christian principles. Although Qigong is not a religion and requires no change in a belief system, the balance and peace one feels after doing these exercises will extend to all aspects of one's life. Master Duan, who has been studying Wu Ji, Qigong, and martial arts since he was 7 years old, is a doctor of traditional Chinese medicine who is renowned for his compassion and generosity. He typically charges 10 yuan, which is about $1, for a Qigong treatment. Master Duan incorporates acupuncture, moxibustion, and Tuina massage techniques with his Wu Ji Qigong. This means he uses his own Wei Qi, or emitted energy, to restore balance in his patients. It is believed that these energy imbalances lead to all illnesses and ailments. As with all great Qigong masters, the power of their balanced Qi and what they collect from nature actually catalyzes and promotes healing in their patients. To build up his own qi and to maintain his health and mental balance, Master Duan practices Wu Ji Qigong for 1 hour each morning. This is followed by a strenuous kung fu workout, where this 90-year-old master routinely spars with other masters and students one-third his age. Master Duan's Wuji Qigong is an easy-to-learn system that is comprised of 18 individual forms. Each form is designed to energize different internal organs and promote qi energy flow throughout the body. Stretching in various ways both loosens the muscles and tendons while stimulating the 12 acupuncture meridians. This helps to unblock stagnant qi, believed to be the root of physical and mental problems. Wuji Qigong has its roots in sword fighting, the Duan family specialty. Most of the moves are focused on loosening up and strengthening the shoulders, neck, and wrists, keys to winning in battle, and coincidentally, key trouble spots for modern-day computer users. Curiously, Master Duan believes one cannot be a good fighter without being a good healer. On the battlefield, a warrior must be adept at tending to his own wounds and those of his fellow soldiers. The powerful techniques of Qigong were thus coveted as secret knowledge, since holding this information meant having the competitive edge. Even with its deep honor of traditional ways, Master Duan's magic lies in his incredible flexibility. His openness to new ideas and willingness to grow and learn is what he says keeps him young at heart. It is also the essence of his Qigong teaching. Master Duan believes that practicing the slow and specific moves of Qigong helps us to remember that we are all connected through a singular, infinite energy he calls Wu Ji. He believes that understanding the concept of chaos in nature will help us with all we encounter.
The essence of all evolution in nature emerges from chaos. By understanding the infinite energy that is always available to us, we can flow naturally with the chaotic rhythms of the universe. Try to avoid patterns and repetition. Mix things up and let qi flow smoothly. Remain flexible and relaxed in all you do. This is to truly understand Qigong.
Master Duan says experiencing the deep and synchronized breathing of Qigong connects us to the original breath that created the universe. A true master, Duan Zhiliang, is consumed with his passion. He teaches constantly at parks around the city and has recently started teaching foreign doctors. His wife of 45 years works with him, as she is also a well-respected teacher and healer. The balance of his time is spent treating patients at one of his two simple Qigong clinics located in impoverished neighborhoods in Beijing. He chooses to share his vast knowledge with a wonderful sense of humor and joy. On the outskirts of Beijing is a unique clinic specializing in bone setting, of what we may think of as a combination of chiropractic and physical therapy. It's a family-run business founded by the 92-year-old Master Lo, the matriarch of a healing dynasty that spans five generations. Dozens of family members work together. Her son, the clinic's director, is a Western-trained physician and a Qigong master himself. Master Lo practices a unique style of Qigong that focuses on using qi in conjunction with subtle bone manipulations to cure a variety of physical ailments ranging from common emergencies to various chronic pain syndromes. An average of 80 patients come to this little clinic each day. Master Lo charges a dollar or two per treatment and still uses the same little stick to transmit qi as she has for the past 70 years. Since the age of 10, her life has been based on a devotion to helping people in pain.
One must do good for the country, for others. It keeps you healthy and young. Some patients are rich, some are poor, but you must treat them the same way. Everything I do is for the good of the people.
By focusing qi and her healing intention through a stick or thumb, she's able to ease pain, realign spines, and reset dislocated joints.
I have a very experienced thumb. I've used my big finger for more than 70 years. It's very important. If you invite me to America to teach, I only have to bring my thumb.
This clinic has an X-ray machine, which each doctor uses for diagnosis. Dr. Lo is proud of the way this clinic is open to Western techniques and any modality that will help their patients heal faster. The open-mindedness of the Lo family, like many Qigong doctors in China, is part of their great gift. They combine artistry and a deep love of their culture to enhance their ability to heal. Dr. Lo is expert at Tai Chi swords, which helps him to build and balance his internal qi. He enjoys discussing the value of combining Qigong with clinical treatments.
The Chinese have a proverb: it is better not to use a knife when trying to heal someone. Surgery causes much discomfort in a patient. We don't use it unless it's necessary. If Western medicine is best, we use those techniques. If Eastern is correct, we use that. Qigong is useful in treatment and in reducing recovery time. Traditional Chinese medicine says that if the acupuncture meridians move slowly, then things are not well. The patient gets painful sensations. Qi must move through the meridians smoothly in order to heal, and this theory applies to bone-related diseases as well.
At the core of the Lo family philosophy is a desire to help others. Master Lo sees Qigong as intention and where one's heart needs to be.
The force from the heart can do many things. Many forces come from the inside, not only physical strength. I may be 92, but I'm still very forceful. We must do good things for the people, nothing bad. This is a socialist country, after all.
To Master Lo, Qigong is a process of acting from a pure heart, of caring about others, and visualizing wholeness and good health. She is an example of charity and compassion and revered for both her own healing powers and the Qigong techniques that she has passed on to her family and students so that others can live a better life. Dr. Wang Su-jen is a unique example of the new generation of Qigong masters to emerge in modern China. At 43 years old, Master Wan has been studying Qigong and traditional Chinese medicine for 36 years. His mother is a renowned acupuncturist in Datong, a coal mining city far in the north of the country. His father, a retired director of a large government-run Western hospital, now assists his wife in their clinic, naturally combining Western procedures with traditional acupuncture. They're proud of their son, who was set on his path to become a healer when he was only 7, and who is now considered one of the most respected Qigong doctors in the country.
People come here from all over the world for treatment, sometimes nearly dying. How great it is that we can take ideas from the Chinese traditional I Ching and Bagua that are thousands of years old and use them to keep us in good health today. We must continue to do research, though, to constantly improve on the past.
In his own clinic and training facility nestled in the outskirts of Beijing, Master Wan has created a learning environment where young students can take up Qigong as a vocational skill. Some 40 students at a time are under his tutelage, following the age-old tradition of learning from a master, but with the added practicality of job placement. The prerequisite for these students is 3 years of study at the Shaolin Temple, where their strenuous, round-the-clock training brings them discipline in the fundamentals of Qigong and Kung Fu. As many of the students arrive here at age 15, it means their family sent them to Shaolin at the age of 11 or 12, taking them out of the traditional schooling and into this live-in learning environment. What these young people lack in geometry and science, they more than make up with practical medical training and an inner strength and humbleness that one rarely sees in their generation. Master Wan, a father himself with the state limit of one child, is a born leader. He has served 30 years in the Red Army, rising high in the ranks while pursuing his medical career. His strength in Qigong brought him notoriety and freedom within the military establishment, and he was given his own Qigong hospital. He has now created a unique training facility where patients from all over the world are treated, as his reputation as a healer continues to rise. Master Wan combines an ancient Taoist Qigong system called Bagua Shundao Gong with traditional Chinese medicine to achieve his great success with paralysis, cancer patients, and a wide variety of diseases. This system of Qigong utilizes the practitioner's emitted Wei Qi to affect the Qi field of the patient. The Qigong practitioners help to restore a healthy balance by moving their hands in a specific way around the patient. It is believed that everyone has a qi field around and through them. The proper manipulation of this field is a step in the process of healing. This manipulation is done by the passing of the practitioner's hand through this field and helping to bring about a shift and restructuring of qi while infusing them with qi from nature. Some practitioners seem to have better success than others, and Master Wan's unique style of having several Qigong doctors working on a single patient has proven to bring about profound and lasting results. He continually explores new techniques and combines them with his emitted Qi treatments. Like all Qigong masters, Dr. Wan practices inner and outer exercises to replenish and strengthen his qi. The strenuous regimen he puts his students through has helped to create a powerful team of young Qigong masters. He constantly lectures on the importance of this self-discipline, not only for the practitioner, but also for the patient. A major key in successful Qigong healing is follow-up practice by the patient after the treatment, and this is what he attributes to his high success rate. Master Wan's Japanese patients have created rehabilitation groups where they loyally practice Qigong exercises after they return home from their week-long treatment. As a Taoist, Master Wan's Qigong training emphasizes a connection with nature, gathering yin qi from the earth and yang qi from the sky. He teaches that this balance of yin and yang from the universe around us reflects the inner balance that we need in order to heal. Healing in the Qigong philosophy is not only of the body, but also of the mind and spirit. These three aspects of our nature are inseparable, and thus must be treated as a coherent whole. Like Master Duan and Master Lo, Master Wan lives by the philosophy that compassion and virtue are the keys to a healthy life and to success as a healer. Money should never be a motivating force, as it will only weaken your qi. They all believe that if you follow the path of a virtuous life and a life of balance, you will be provided for in ways that are best suited for your unfolding and growth. Qigong has also captured the interest of the scientific community. Their hope is to somehow quantify qi and then regenerate it. The leading pioneer in this area is Lu Yanfeng, affectionately known as Engineer Lu. Her groundbreaking work at the Electroacoustical Research Institute is well respected around the world. 15 years ago, Engineer Lu had the idea that the qi emissions from Qigong masters could be somehow measured acoustically. In the Institute's anechoic chamber, she suspended a highly sensitive microphone near the Lao Gong point in their palms, the traditional acupressure point where its healing qi is emitted. Upon demand, these masters could emit a low-frequency audio signal in the 8 to 14 hertz range. It was a chaotic signal with an ever-changing pattern. She tested many average adults who showed no such pattern, but did find that young children exhibited similar audio emissions. The result of this research was the development of the Qigong machine, a handheld device that actually replicates this audio portion of the qi emission. Co-developed and marketed by China Healthways in San Clemente, California, this device is used by thousands of physicians and chiropractors in the United States. Testimonials of chronic pain relief, energy boosting, and the reduction of swelling from sprains are numerous. Although qi is considered by authorities to be a more complex radiation than just an audio waveform, the Qigong machine is an example of what may lie ahead as we take Qigong more seriously and delve deeper into the mysterious nature of qi. Applying scientific research methods to obtain results on the healing properties of qi has its challenges, but is leading us to a deeper understanding of this elusive force. Dr. Kenneth Sancier, president and founder of the Qigong Institute in Menlo Park, California, is considered one of the foremost authorities on this field of research. Now retired from his 35-year tenure as director of the Stanford Research Institute, his deep respect by the international scientific community brings credibility and objectivity to Qigong research.
Well, I think we have to look to China for the find out what kind of research is going on. Over the period of since 1980s, a huge amount of research has been reported in the literature, but that literature is mainly in Chinese, so in order to make that information accessible to Western people, the Qigong Institute put together a Qigong, computerized Qigong database, which permits people to search with any keyword for a disease or any other condition. And there are about 1,300 references in that database. There's been research done on showing that emitted qi sent from a Qigong master will increase the rate of growth of seedlings, mushrooms. Qigong is a therapy for chronic conditions primarily, although not exclusively, whereas Western medicine is primarily for acute conditions like surgery or bacterial infections and so forth. So the Western and the Eastern approach can be worked together, and they should be complementary because they're dealing with different aspects of healing.
Most of the exploration into the healing powers of Qigong is going on outside of the laboratories. In parks throughout China, over 80 million people practice Qigong each day. You can witness the myriad styles in any town and province you visit. The therapeutic aspects of this healthcare system are usually achieved through slow-moving exercises, yet some styles involve simply sitting. Others would rather apply it to what looks like traditional dancing. From here in Shanghai to 1,000 miles away in Laoyang, massive crowds dance their Qigong to the guidance of a master instructor. Another aspect of Qigong lies within Tai Chi swordplay. Like Master Duan, these students believe the metal in the sword helps to absorb qi into their bodies. Most people may not think of calligraphy as Qigong, but several master artists are renowned for their healing powers that they impart through their artwork. It is believed that their powerful qi is passed into the finished piece and can benefit those who view it. 84-year-old Master Lu lives in Chengdu, an ancient city near the Tibetan border of China. He sees the paintbrush and the sword as one and the same, as it is qi that animates them both. His grace and elegance are the reflection of the refined qi he has cultivated over years of study. At Master Zhang's Heavenly Dragon Temple, loyal students are taught the subtle aspects of strengthening and applying qi to all they do. Across the country at the Shi Fun Yuan Temple, Master Sun Ming Ri creates beautiful artwork while in a deep Qigong meditation. A Taoist monk, he lives an austere life in this mountaintop retreat. He says that he never had any artistic tendencies until late in his 80-year life. One day, after years of Qigong practice in one of the temple's gardens, he said he saw the essence of the flowers in that moment and deeply understood his connection to them. He picked up a paintbrush for the first time and began to paint. His art is now considered a national treasure, and each piece he finishes is carefully wrapped and shipped to an official caretaker in Beijing. This Taoist temple is typical in that all of the monks are trained to apply their Qigong to creative outlets. These monks, or Daosha, are vegetarian musicians. They play traditional Taoist temple music in a heightened Qigong state, thus imparting to the listener the strength and healing balance of their qi. A small group has been trained since childhood to develop their qi in order to perform extraordinary physical feats. Much like the Shaolin monks with their acts of supreme skill, these young men focus much of their waking energy to mastering techniques that defy physics. These feats are part of their Qigong training. By learning to build their Wei Qi, or protective Qi, they are able to strengthen their bodies in order to master these skills. These extreme feats serve to inspire others to practice even basic Qigong techniques for self-healing and general well-being. In Tibet, Qigong seems to be incorporated into the very fabric of daily life for these gentle Buddhists. When we think of this country, we are reminded of the austere life of the monks who live in the few remaining temples throughout this magical land. Their Qigong is practiced in prayer, mostly performed in silence or with gentle chanting. For the Tibetans, the use of repetitive sounds or mantras is key to obtaining the healing benefits of Qigong. The average Tibetan journeys to a temple each week and walks around and around it, chanting a specific mantra. Coming on horseback or by foot for miles along severe terrain, the Tibetan knows the value of this walking Qigong practice. To these spiritual people, each moment of every day is an opportunity to honor life, to appreciate the beauty and power of the universe, and to accept all that comes to them with an open and loving heart. Within China, like all growing industrialized countries, there is a major concern about managing the healthcare needs of the people. As in the West, rising healthcare costs are presenting a tremendous financial burden on valuable limited resources. The Chinese government has been looking seriously at the possibility of Qigong to relieve some of this pressure. Deep in Hebei province, Master Zhe Chen Guo has been developing a Qigong style that he feels is actually transcending what we know as Qigong. His system is known as Zhenang medicine and combines Qigong with both traditional Chinese medicine and Western medical theory. 2 million loyal students practice it regularly and claim incredible results. At his treatment center, an 1,100-bed clinic is combined with an herbal pharmacy and training center capable of handling 5,000 students at one time. The select students that are invited to come here travel by bicycle and bus from around China to learn from Master Guo. They believe his qi energy, combined with the various exercises they perform for hours at a time, help in their training and healing. In fact, many come here to heal themselves from all forms of disease. Guo's system involves both Qigong exercises and various herb combinations that he prescribes just by glancing at the patient. With his team of doctors, he is able to treat hundreds of people a day at his clinic. Because of these profound results, this low-cost and effective system appeals greatly to the government. Many Zhenang medicine support groups are growing around the country and are overseen by local government agencies that are proud of the responsibility individuals are taking to maintain their health. Master Guo is now hoping to share his system with Westerners. To this end, he has selected a renowned Chinese medical doctor to be his representative in the West. This man, Dr. Zhu Gangxia, is both a Western-trained physician as well as a traditional Chinese doctor who has taught in Beijing at the World Health Organization's International Medical Center. Dr. Xia, a Qigong master who began his training at the age of 7, is now the adopted son of Master Guo and has been given the responsibility of spreading the healing power of Zhenang medicine to the West. Dr. Xia has moved to Canada and has recently visited America to begin this process of teaching what he and Master Guo feel will be the force of self-healing for the 21st century. The system utilizes special sounds and hand positioning to help unblock stagnant qi that causes chronic pain. For difficult cases, he uses a unique form of acupuncture that utilizes only 12 acupoints. Dr. Xia inserts the needles very quickly, but says he uses his qi to enhance the healing effects. The claims of his healing abilities and those of the various Zhenang medicine techniques grow daily, and Western physicians are beginning to take a serious look at how these new healing modalities may eventually complement Western medicine. Qigong, a 5,000-year-old healing modality, has evolved and adapted itself to the times, continuously molded by its various teachers. Although thousands of different styles have emerged over the millennia, the common threads that tie sincere proponents of this healing system together remain the same. The first key is the breath. Every form of Qigong puts great emphasis on deep diaphragmatic breathing. Though there may be many techniques to manipulate the breath, the fact remains that if one can devote some attention to focused yet relaxed deep breathing, they will experience a certain level of benefit. As relaxation relieves the body of stress, the immune system has less work to do, and more energy can be devoted to staying healthy. Intentional deep breathing will also supply the body with more oxygen, the fuel it needs to repair and maintain health. The second key is slow, gentle movement and stretching. With physical flexibility comes mental flexibility. When deep breath is combined with slow, synchronized movement, the body builds more energy, or qi, rather than depleting energy, which happens with strenuous exercise. When the body moves with the breath, many people experience a sense of calm and harmony. This sensation helps to bring the body and mind into balance and contributes to our physical and mental healing. Qigong is not tied to any religious belief system. Although it has been influenced over the millennia by much philosophical thought, people from all walks of life practice Qigong. It is common that practitioners experience both a deep sense of calm and increased vitality. Many say it has changed the way they look at life, as if their senses have just been awakened. Many authorities agree that healing is heavily influenced by one's state of mind. It is thought that if a person is more positive and at ease, they will successfully contribute to their own healing. Qigong appears to have the potential of being a simple technique that can be learned by anyone and provides tangible results that even scientists can quantify. Of great interest to all is that practicing Qigong can cut down hospitalization, time, and cost, reduce the amount of medication one needs during convalescence, and promote healing in diseases ranging from hypertension to cancer. In a word, Qigong has the potential of drastically reducing the cost of healthcare. Most importantly, Qigong offers a way for individuals to take responsibility for their own health and to alleviate the sense of helplessness that often exists in today's healthcare system. With healthcare costs skyrocketing, the Chinese and a growing number of Westerners believe Qigong is an opportunity for motivated people to become more involved in their own physical, mental, and spiritual health. Qigong may become a powerful complement to our current healing modalities. It is an ancient Chinese healing system that honors the past and provides the tools that can enable us to truly help others and ourselves as we enter the 21st century.